This week, we are going to talk about how to get your Facebook pixel set up, what your Facebook pixel is, what your Facebook pixel can do for you, and how you can use it moving forward once you get it set up to collect data and use that data to enhance and grow your business, knowing that you are targeting an active and engaged audience that want everything that you have to offer. Why do I know that they do? Because we're using the Facebook pixel. And that is going to be the powerhouse of today's tutorial. So we're just really going to focus on getting things set up. And then in next week's tutorial, we will actually show you some ways to use the data that you've collected and turn that into money. So let's get into it. Be sure to download your checklist for getting your Facebook pixel set up below. Stick around to the end of the video and we will explain it in detail. All right, we are in our Facebook Business Manager, and the first thing that we want to do to get our pixel set up is pop over to the left-hand side over here where it says Business Manager, and you'll get the little menu here. So click it, you get a little drop down, and you can see that in my frequently used items, pixels is right here. But if yours is not, then you hover down over all tools and slide over to the fourth column, assets. So we have plan, create and manage, measure and report, and assets. And your pixels are what Facebook deems an asset to your advertising account and your business account. So click on pixels. And right now I am in the test account, so we haven't created a pixel, so let's go ahead and create a pixel for this account. It's going to ask us a couple questions, so we just want to name the pixel. Test accounts pixel is totally fine. Do remember though that for each ad account you only get one pixel, and that can get confusing if you're trying to use your Facebook pixel on multiple different websites or streams of websites that are coming into your website or your offer, whatever it is. Probably not very applicable to many of you, but if you're starting out as an agency or something and you are doing Facebook ads for people, make sure that instead of using your own business ads account, ads manager account, you're actually creating a new ads account for those clients. It'll just make things a lot easier. So obviously we have to agree to the terms, and we'll click next, and there we go. We are all set up. Now let's make it work. So we can set up the integration or use Tag Manager. I personally just like using the copy and paste method, so let's go with that route. Okay, so we want to install the Facebook Pixel base code, as you see here, and they kind of walk us through the steps. So we want to locate the header code for our website, which in any website that you have or anyone else has, there are basic components to literally every website. Every website has a head section. So what Facebook is telling us to do is saying we must install the pixel base code into the header code for every page of the website. This lets us gather data about all page views on the website to establish a baseline for measuring specific events, and we'll get to events shortly. So we need to locate this section, the head, so in our tags here. And to give you an example of what this looks like, we will pop over to our code editor here. And I've already copied the code in, but so here's what it looks like without the code. So right here, in every site, you'll see this. If you have access to the actual HTML files, say if you're using a WordPress site or anything that's self-hosted, you will have access to this as long as you have, you know, FTP access or anything else that you can actually see the code and then re-upload the file. Now, if you're using a predefined website that offers you services like Squarespace or Shopify, they'll have sections for you to get in and pop this code in. Some of them actually have direct integrations that can kind of do this for you. You just paste a small section of this code rather than the entire block that they tell you to copy. But so we want to have the Facebook code installed here on our page, And so that's what I've done. I've copied it into the head section, exactly what they want us to do. So we've copied that, and we're going to move to our next phase, which is actually testing it on the website. So let's move over to an opt-in that we already have pre-built and show you exactly what this looks like. So here's our page. It's a little opt-in. We download our guide, three-step guide to use Facebook for growing your business. And you know, if you opt in here, if we click the button, we'll move to the next step. But first, I want to show you what this looks like. So if we right-click and do view page source, then we can see where our Facebook tag is. So here's our Facebook pixel right here. And you can see that we have our Facebook ID, we have it set to page view, and this is the default status for it. So one really cool thing, if you're using the Chrome browser, is this little Chrome extension called the Facebook Pixel Helper. Now this is a really quick way to make sure that Facebook is able to gain access to the Facebook Pixel. It's all installed properly, and you literally just install the extension, and on any web page that has the Facebook Pixel installed, you'll be able to see that it's firing. So let's go ahead and open it up, and you can see that our Facebook ID here is the same ID. If we go back and view that page source again, so it's going to be the same number here that it is here. Same number. And we are looking for the page view event. So this is just a standard event that Facebook starts us all with. And this is how they know basically what they're forming as a baseline of information of people who visit your site, who they are, how long they stay on the site, where they are, and some other metadata information that just kind of helps them understand a bit more about who is actually visiting your site, who finds it valuable, and how they can eventually find more of those people. So let's go ahead and move back to the Pixel Manager, and we'll move to our next step, which is installing our event code. So we get a whole list of, and we can read through all this. Basically, it's just saying events are, these are standard predefined events that Facebook has given us the use of so that we can keep track on a more specific level of the type of actions that people are taking when we are sending them to an opt-in or showing them products to buy. They're adding items to a cart, they're initiating checkout, but maybe they're not following through. So we can use all of this data in the future when we create ads, retargeting ads, remarketing ads, and then re-engage with people. That's kind of the whole point of this, is that we want to be building an audience. We want to be able to target these people, and we want to show them either a new offer or the same offer, but maybe from a different angle, or just remind them that, hey, you were interested in this, and we noticed that you dropped off for some reason. So it's another way to get in front of people, to remind them that you are actually here to help them and provide them a product or service that adds value to their life. All goes back to adding value. So these are some of the events. We've got search, view content, add to cart, add to wish list, initiate checkout, add payment info, purchase, lead, complete registration. And then down here, you'll see we can actually create our own custom event. And basically, all of these events, you'll see they have a name. So you'll have the FBQ track, and that's just saying that we want to track. And then you'll see the next bit, which is in this sense, complete registration. So what Facebook is listening for is this particular event fires and it says complete registration. So Facebook knows that this is what I'm listening for. I know that at this point in a person's journey to this point, they have taken other steps along the way. And this is how I know what to track this person as. And that can be so valuable, especially if you have opt-in offers that have multiple stages, or let's say you have a sales funnel that starts with some sort of free giveaway and then leads them into a small purchase and then leads them into a larger purchase. We can actually set these Facebook pixels up to track in a specific way that we can then listen for these events to fire and track that data in Facebook so that we can then target those areas specifically. So if we're getting a lot of leads but not a lot of sales, then we know that something is wrong with our funnel at that point. if we're getting a lot of clicks on our ads, but we're not getting a lot of leads, people that actually give us their information, then we know that the landing page initially that people hit from the ad is not compelling enough. It's not giving them that I need to do this feeling, and they're not taking the next step, which means those people are missing out on every other step of the funnel. So you can kind of see how this gets to be so super powerful. So for us, we're targeting a lead with our little opt-in page, and let's show you what that looks like. So we're back over here on our page, and if we go ahead, again, I pre-filled this out, Facebook Pixel Demo at getquirk.co. We go ahead and get our guide. It submits and takes us to the next step. So thanks for downloading. Just sent your three-step guide to the email, blah, blah, blah. But we can now look up here and we see before we had two events firing. Now we have three. So let's look and see what that is. So for us, we're actually targeting the complete registration. So page view, again, is our basic. That should fire on every page of our website because it should be installed on every page of our website. And then the specific event, complete registration, that will only fire in this sense when someone opts in to take our offer. So we'll look and see in here, and then we can actually pop back over to Facebook and look at that data to see how many people have actually gone there and learn more things about them. So the last step in setting up our events is to take our event code here, and we want to copy that, and where we would want to put it, let's see, let's open this back up. So we'll view the page source of this page, and we will look for complete registration. So right here you'll see that we have put this right before our closing body tag, and if we pop back over to our little HTML example, you'll see that we can either put it within the footer or we can just simply put it right before this closing body tag. And that's really all that Facebook needs. It just needs it to be still within the HTML document, but what it's looking for is the actual content of the page to house your event code. And that's really important because this is going to be our Facebook base code. The Pixel base code is always going to be on the page. It's up in the head section, which should be the same on every page of your website, or at least very similar. There should be components that are all the same. But the body section of every page can be different, and in often cases, it is. So we want to make sure that our event fires on our specific pages so that we're not tracking all of this stuff on every page for tracking our lead, or in our case, the complete registration. So that's all we're looking for. We want it to be very specific. We want it to be on a specific action that a person has taken. So has taken, meaning not the actual page on which the action takes place, but where the action takes them to fire that event. So you can see here, we have it just below our closing body tag on the page, and that's how we know using the Facebook Pixel Helper that that's where it is on the page, and we know that it's not firing on the previous page because if we hit our back button, we can see that it's no longer there. We're just tracking the page view. So now that we have set up our code here, I'm gonna pop over to the account we actually have information on. So now we can see kind of the actions that we have had taken on our pixels and where those things are. So these are some of the events that we have tracked. And you can see that these are kind of old things we had going. So these have no activity, but all these are active. So we've got our view content, we've got page view. Page view should be firing on everything. So you can see it's typically gonna have the most amount of traffic. And now we can look at our lead. Our lead has fired 30 times in the past couple days, so that's excellent. Our complete registration for that funnel, that this funnel over here, we can see that it is fired just a couple times. And that's really because we're just starting this process to drive traffic there. So events for today are updated hourly, So right now they're tracking basically us to see this page, and that's all that we've had today. But you can actually see the dates here as you scroll through, and then if we want, we can dive in a little bit better, and we'll see that, yep, it tracked us from taking that click, Facebook Pixel Demo at getquirk.co.
Now you know how to get your Facebook Pixel set up, why it's important to have, how the data can be tracked, and why it is important to actually track that data. Next week, we're going to go over some ways that you can use that data that you're tracking now and start building an audience, building leads, getting new customers, and really turning that Facebook Pixel data and all of your presence online into money. So stay tuned for next week. If you like this video, please like below and be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all the new videos that we come out with on using Facebook for business and staying up to date with the platform. I am Matt from Get Quirked. I'll see you next week.